Okay, good morning everyone. Okay, myself Gaurang Kaushik Kumar Chapanari, Assistant Professor Mechanical Engineering Department, RNGPIT, Bardoli. Okay, today we discuss in the sixth semester subject, Industrial Engineering, and the subject code is 2161907. Okay, today we discuss the sequencing technique. Okay, sequencing technique is a part of PPC. PPC means production planning and control. Okay, it's a part of PPC. In PPC, just we just give overview of the PPC. Process planning is also termed as a routing. The process planning is an intermediate step between the product planning and the manufacturing. So the process planning is the part of production system in which the complete planning starting from selection of process and its parameter. So in that, the machine tools, equipment, and most important sequence of the process means sequence of the job of the process for the converting raw material into the final product. Okay, the sequencing is a part of PPC, is the most important role. Okay, today we discuss in a part one. This sequencing technique we divide in a three group: part one, part two, and part two, part three. Sorry. So today we discuss part one. So first we understand the sequencing concept. Actually, what is sequencing? Okay, sequencing is nothing but is a priority. Which job we have to select? We cannot select randomly. So there are different techniques, different methods we have to follow. So we can reduce the time. The main purpose is to reduce the time. So we understand the meaning first. Sequencing is also termed as a prioritization. Okay, I already told you sequencing is simple priority. In other words, sequencing means grouping production operation into the production batches and arranging them by priority. Okay, means simple is a priority which we have to select first. In that, there is some prism condition for sequencing. So we have to take one by one point. Simple, first set at times single operation is carried out on a machine. Okay, is the most important, only single time. Second, time of performing the operation is known. Okay, we know the operation, which operation we have to perform. Once the job is started, it's unloaded only when it's completed. In between, we cannot unload the job. When the job machine is completed, then and then we can unload the part or job. Okay, an operation must be completed before its succeeding operation can start. Time of shifting job is negligible. And the last point, time of performing the operation is independent on the sequence of the job. Okay, so this is the basic condition requirement or condition, or we can say requirement of the sequencing. Okay, let's go. Now next, there are different types of sequencing process. Okay, the first is end job one machine, second end job two machine, third end job three machine, and the last two job on M machine. Okay, this is a sequencing technique or sequencing problem or sequencing method. Okay, basically a simple four method: end job one machine, end job two machine, end job three machine, and last two job on M machine. Okay, all the methods is very simple and frequently asked in an exam. Okay, today we discuss end job one machine. Okay, now what is end job one machine and how to solve the example? It's very simple method or simple technique, so you can easily acquire the marks. Okay, first end job one machine. See, the same sentence is end job one machine. Means we can easily understand in that only one machine and we have to perform the number of job is called the n job one machine. Simple. Okay, when there is a one machine to perform the n job, in n job was one machine, we have to apply the SPT rule. SPT is nothing but shortest processing time. In n job one machine, just we have to apply simple SPT rule and we get the answer within a minute. Okay, that is, complete the job which has minimum time for completion. In that, we have to find out the minimum time, completion of minimum time. So this will reduce the main waiting time as well as main lateness. Okay, lateness we will discuss in the example. Okay, now next part. So now take one example. The process time for a 5 job and due date or days of the job are given in the following table. Okay, this is the example. N job one machine. Okay, here we have only one machine. Okay, and we have to perform the 5 job. In that we provided processing time in days and due dates. Okay, so only we have 2 data available, processing time and due date. So in that, first we have to find the sequence and days according to the following rule. Okay, just we have to find down the sequence of the job, that's it, nothing else. So first we have to find out the minimum processing time. Second, FCFS is the first come first serve. Third, due dates in a days. Okay, so n job one machine, in that we already told you, in that we have to perform the, in that we have to use the SPT rule, shortest processing time. Okay, first we find out minimum processing time. Okay, in minimum processing time, here we have 5 job number 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, and the processing time is available for the first job is completed in a 3 days. Second job is completed in a 6 days. Third job completed in 9 days. Fourth job completed in a 5, and similarly job number 5 is completed in 7. So just we have to find out the minimum processing time. Okay, as per the SPT rule, shortest processing time. So what is the sequence? The minimum time on a machine 1, 3 days. The next job number 4, 5 days. The next job number 2, 6 days. Job number 5, 7 days. And the last job number 3 in a 9 days. Okay, this is simple SPT rule. So we have to find out the optimal sequence. Okay, this is SPT rule we have to apply and we have to find out the minimum processing time. Okay, this is the sequence of the job. As per the MPT, minimum processing time, first we have to operate job number 1, then 4, then 2, 5 and 3. So this is the sequence of the job. So the processing time, take the total processing time is 30 days. Okay, it's only one job, n job, one machine. So processing time should be same in all the condition, MPT, FCFS or due date. So next, we have to find out first come, first serve. Okay, in a first come, first serve means, here the 5 job, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so we have to select job number 1, then job number 2, then job number 3, 4 and 5. So this is the first come, first serve. See, when we go in the bank, or we suppose we have to take the money in ATM card, so at that time, we have used the FCFS, first come, first serve. Okay, it's a simple technique, simple method. Okay, as per the FCFS rule, the sequence of the job is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So this is the sequence, first come, first serve. And same thing, the processing time, 3, 6, 9, 5, 7 is given is 3, 6, 9, just summation of the processing time, so 30 days. And the last, due date in days. Okay, same thing, sequence of the due date. So the minimum due days in a job number one. Okay, so first we have to operate job number one. The next minimum processing time on a job number four. Okay, here the due date is 12 days. Okay, then job number two, 20 days. The next job number five, 25, and the last job number three, 30 days. So as per the due date, the sequence of the job is 1, 4, 2, 5, and 3. So let's take processing time is a 30 days. Okay, this is a simple example in GTO, frequently asked in example, and 7 marks. Okay, now take next example. Okay, example number two. The following tables contains information regarding your jobs that are waiting to be processed at a work center. Okay, same thing, N job, one machine. Okay, here we have 4 jobs, A, B, C, and D, and only one machine. Here same thing is processing time is provided and due date is provided. So here we have to find out sequencing job using first SPT method, okay, sorted processing time method. Second, processing with due dates. Assume the list is by order of arrival. For each of the methods, determine the average job flow time and average lateness. So here we have to find out the lateness. Okay. Now take the solution. First, as per the SPT sorted processing time, okay. Okay, as per the SPT minimum processing time, the sequence of the job is D, C, B, A. So here we write down D, C, B, A. Okay, clear? Second thing, processing time. Processing time is already given in example. Okay, in a job number D, the processing time is 6 days. Sorry. Job number C, the processing time is 7 days. Similarly, job number B, processing time is 10 days. And the last job number A, the processing time is 14. Okay, just we have to follow the minimum processing time or sorted processing time, SPT rule. So this is a sequence of the job D, C, B, and A. Same thing, we have to follow the due dates, the minimum, same thing, job number D, 17, 15, 16, and 20. Clear? Now, in that, we have to find out the average job flow time. We have to find out the average job flow time and lateness. Okay, now how to find out the flow time? Flow time is also called as opening time. Okay. Okay, the flow time is simple, the initial processing time. Okay, the first processing time is six days. In before there are no any job. So flow time is 6. The next job number C, flow time in the previous job number D is take 6 days, and here job number C take 7 days. Okay, the summation of this 6 plus 7 is equal to 13. It's very simple. 6 plus 7 is equal to 13. Similarly, for a job B, 13 plus 10 is equal to 23. Okay. And the last, A, 23 plus 14 is equal to 37. So here we find out the flow time on each job. In a job D, we get 6 days, job C 13 days, job B 23 days, and job A 37 days. So this is the flow time of the job. Now how to find out the lateness? Okay, lateness is nothing but, okay, just 1 minute. Here we give the definition is so you can easily understand. Lateness is nothing but is a calculated by subtracting the due date from the opening to flow time. Okay, is nothing but the flow time and due date. okay, subtracting the due date from the opening or floor time. Okay, here the lateness is 0. Okay, the floor time is 6 and due date is 17. Okay, the lateness is 0. Similarly, the floor time is 13 and due date is 15. Okay, so again is 0. Okay, when the higher value of floor time in due date, at that time we have to consider the lateness. If the value is negative, so always we have to consider lateness is 0. 6 minus 17 is minus 11, so we have to consider lateness is 0. Same thing, 13 minus 15 minus 2 means lateness is 0. Now next, floor time 23 minus 16, so here we get the positive value. Okay, so lateness is 7 days. Okay, and the next, 37 minus 20, so here we get the 17. Okay, now here we have to find out the average floor time. Okay, here is given to determine the average job floor time and average lateness. Is very simple. So how to find out the average floor time? Okay, just simple. Summation of the floor time divided by number of job. Summation of all the floor times divided by number of job. Okay, so the floor time is 6 plus 13 plus 23 plus 37. Okay, and the total number of job is 4, A, B, C, D or D, C, B, A. Okay, so summation is 79, okay, divided by 4. So we get the average floor time, 19.75 days. You can write out 20 days. Okay, similarly, find out the average lateness. 0 plus 0 plus 7 plus 17 divided by number of job 4. So 24 divided by 4 to 6 day. So lateness is 6 days. Okay, here is simple example. Just we have to average floor time is simple. Summation of all the floor time divided by total number of job. So we can easily find out average floor time. Similarly, lateness. Same thing also we can find out the FCFS. Same procedure we have to apply. Okay, here we find out SPD rule. Now next, we have to find out as per the due date. Same method. Okay, as per the due date, the sequence is CBDA. Okay, minimum processing time or minimum due date. You know, job number C is 15, then 16, 17, and 20. Okay, so here we have to apply the due dates. We have to follow the due date SPD rule. Sequence is CBDA. Same thing, we have to find out the floor time is simple. 7 initial. 7 processing time to 7. In the next, 7 plus 10 is equal to 17. Next, 7 plus 6 is equal to 23. 23 plus 14 is equal to 57. Okay, clear? It's very simple. Again, find out lateness. 7 minus 15 minus 8. So consider lateness is 0 always. 17 minus 16 plus 1. So we have to consider lateness 1. 23 minus 17. So lateness is 6. 37 minus 20, lateness is 17. So we can easily find out lateness. Same thing, average floor time is a summation of all the floor time divided by total number of job. Okay, 7 plus 17 plus 23 plus 37 divided by number of job. Here we have 4 job. So summation is 84 divided 4 means 21 days. Okay, same thing, average lateness. Okay, summation of all the lateness divided by number of job. 0 plus 1 plus 6 plus 17 divided by 4. So total 24 divided by 4 is equal to 6 days. Okay, clear? Okay, thank you. If you have any query or suggestion, please contact me on my mobile number as well as you can direct email me. Okay, thank you.